You already have an Azure Static Web App deploy in Azure with an API, but now you would like to limit the access. In this video, I want to show you how you could use multiple different providers to secure your application. I'm Frank Boucher, and today we're talking Azure Static Web App. The code is already done. You have your API, you have your app, and now you would like to add some authentication and authorization. We'll show you how. So here I am in Visual Studio Code, and the first thing we want to do is add here the library. And right now it's in pre-release version, but maybe when you will see this video, it will be the full release. That will give us the library we need to add the authentication. I already did all the changes to avoid typing while I'm recording, but I will show you in each page what I did changed. So the first, we start with program.cs, and we'll add here, if I zoom just a little bit, this section where to the builder, we add the add static web app authentication. That's it. And you just need to add, obviously, the Microsoft Azure function authentication WebAssembly, the library that we just had previously in the package. Our next step will be in the app.razor. So now what we need to do is here, add that cascading authentication state and specify that the authorize root view. This way we'll be able to see only when we allowed people. Our next stop will be to really change the visibility of our main layout. So go to mainlayout.razor page, and now we'll add here, instead of just showing the about when we use the scaffolding, now we'll say, you know what, when it's authorized, show me my name and the logout button. And if I'm not authorized, mean I'm not logged in yet, well, show me a login link. So I could open a link page and connect. Talking about logging in, I need a page for that. So let's add one. There's multiple providers supported. We'll see the complete list in a few seconds, but in this demo, I will use GitHub, Twitter, and the Microsoft Active Directory. So here, to support, have the choice, the options. I'm building that little things, and here why I have this strange library, just because I'm using awesome font and like to have the icon and like the color and text, I needed to have different names. That's it. But I'm just displaying three different buttons, and I will go here when you click on that, send people to the auth login and then the provider value. So it will be AAD, Twitter, or GitHub. That's it. So now we have a login. Let's add some security or authentication to our application. You know what? In fetch data, usually it just get and fetch data. We'll secure that, but just by using here, if you already did some ASP.NET or something like that, you're familiar with the attribute authorize. So what that means is now this page, you only can see it if you're authenticated. Anybody could use any Twitter, GitHub, Facebook, whatever account. They just need to be authenticated and they will be able to see that page. Excellent. But sometimes we want to own and decide who can see a permission, a page. So that's when we need roles, and that's supported in Azure DevOps. So I created another page. Let's zoom out. A page that I called secured. This page is very, very simple. And what I did is I'm using here the same attribute authorized, but I specify the role admin. And that's my decision. It could have been anything. I just decided it will be admin. We need to remember that because later on, we'll need to assign that role to someone. And here we can see that I'm just calling a new API that we'll create in 2 seconds. And doing the path API secure LOU, and I'm still passing the name in the query string. Now, let's go on the API side and just create that function. So here, I already did that. The only difference here is I added a root with the secure LOU. So I could have different routes to help me manage the security. That's always very useful. And also I added a claim. So this way I could check if the claim exists and stuff like that. Obviously right now I'm just looking at it and logging the information if it's false, but you could do many more with that. And that's it. That's the only thing. I will be returning secure HTTP in the message if it worked. And as a response, just like before, I will return a message, but I specify that it's a secure HTTP function, just, you know, so we know it's our new function. So already have this, it's already pushing GitHub in a different branch, so I could see preview. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, look that other video where I explain how you can leverage a CI/CD to preview the changes before going live. So now what we'll do is go in GitHub. I have this already open. That's perfect. I can open it in a different tab. Here I have. I see here in the corner, I have my login. So it means it's the new version. I could now go in counter. I have my button just like before. And now if I go and fetch data, well, not authorized, but that's exactly what we expect because I'm not logged in. So let's log in. So we'll go log in. And for this is our login page we create with the three button, like I told you. Let's use Twitter for now. Voila. So now we can see that I'm logged in as FButcherRose. That's my Twitter. By the way, if you have any questions, ping me there. And now if I go fetch data, I see fetch data. But if I click on the secure, still not authorized. Why? Because I don't have the role yet. So let's add that role. So to do that, what we need to do is go on the portal. So portal.azure.com. Here I am in my static web app, simple demo. I have all the setting. And if I look here on the left, I have role management. So I will click there. And here I can create invites and assign the role I want. So let's create a new one. And here we have the complete list that I was talking earlier. So we have Azure Active Directory, GitHub, Facebook, Twitter, and Google. That's all the providers that are supported right now. So you know what? Let's try Azure Active Directory. So we'll use that. I will use my Microsoft email. And here in this section, that's where I will add my role. So remember, we need the role admin. So we'll just create admin. And that with that, you could create any role you want and have any combination. It will be better to have a better granularity of your permissions. So I'll generate my link, voila. So I just need now to send this invitation. And like I see here, the invitation will be good for 1 hour. So if I need more time, I could specify more time, but it's always good to know that link is not valid forever. So now I will go open that in another tab since I'm the user, voila. So now I will log in using my user. I will grant consent because now there's some authentication going on. And voila. Now what I need to do is go back to my branch, my special branch. I will log out as Twitter and I will log in using my Azure Active Directory. Voila, using the same user. So now I'm logged in. We see here that I have a totally different login than previously. It's not FButcherRose anymore. It's my Microsoft email. And now if I fetch data will still work, but now if I go in secure, padam, it's working. Bonjour, hi, Cloudies. This is the secure HTTP trigger. So that's perfect. So with that, you can add security to your app and have the granularity you want with any role, and that's all free supported natively in Azure. I hope that helps, and stay tuned to learn more.